Welcome back to the Final Fantasy VIII Let's Play Remastered version. Good to see you. Glad you're here. We have a lot to talk about today, and we're about to jump into a big story section, so excuse my rambling, but I do have a few things to say before we start. First of all, thank you guys so much for the support on the Chrono Cross Let's Play. The Chrono Cross Let's Play is officially done now. Uploaded the last episode yesterday, and there was a lot of great like support over me figuring out the color puzzle, and it was like really awesome, so thank you. I loved the Chrono Cross Let's Play. It was a lot of fun. It was fun to do it with everyone, and I'm glad I was able to figure out the last puzzle, so that was fun. So last week we started... S Swing with the 10 months. Appreciate it, my man. Last week we started the Final Fantasy VIII Remastered Let's Play, and I was nice on the I made some jokes, but in general I just tried to enjoy the experience. And I'm still enjoying the experience. I didn't want to go too far into like what I thought about the actual remaster because it just came out. And I wanted to let it kind of sink in a bit. So, it's been a week and it's sunken in. And let me tell you, it's not good. A lot of people are complaining about this remaster. Now, to be fair, this remaster is great for us. We've always wanted to play Final Fantasy VIII. This is a great way for us to play it. You know, it's great for the channel. We get to enjoy Final Fantasy VIII together. Like, it's great for us, right? But, in general, in terms of remasters, this one is pretty poopy for a lot of different reasons. And the general consensus is that they were just lazy. And I don't know if lazy is the right word, because I'm not trying to say, like, legitimately people that work at Square are lazy. But there's an obvious amount of, like, they just did not put a lot of work into this. It was more about getting it out fast rather than putting a lot of work into it. Which, if it just appeared overnight, like, hey, by the way, guys, here's this Final Fantasy VIII remaster, it'd be less annoying. But the fact that they announced it at E3 and made, like, a big deal about it, and then it ends up being a really kind of lazy remaster is frustrating. And there's a lot of different things. You know, first of all, the upscaling is not great. Like, Squall looks good, but, I mean, he better look good. He's the friggin' main character. Everyone else looks okay. Like, certainly it could have been better, but I'm not going to complain too much about that because I don't upscale models. Like, we could ask Suna. He upscales models. We could ask him what he thinks of the upscaling, but for me, like, it looks fine. The biggest problem is the backgrounds. The backgrounds are not upscaled. So, they look better than they did back on your old PS1, PS2, because the console's going through HDMI and, you know, instead of crappy composite cables on a giant CRT TV, you're looking at it through 1080p HDMI on a nice 1080p monitor. But the actual backgrounds are not upscaled. If you play the Steam version, which is just a hard port of the PS1 version, sort of. It's not actually a hard port because they lost the code, but for all intents and purposes, it's a hard port. The backgrounds look just as good. So, they didn't take the time to actually upscale the backgrounds at all. It's only the models that got upscaled. So that's kind of strike number one. Strike two is that the upscaling itself is incredibly lazy. We saw that last week where Cid was part of the background for some reason and looked super blurry. And there's apparently a lot of other places where they missed little spots here and there. So the upscaling itself, which is the only thing this thing has, is the upscaling and the cheats, is lazy. So when the one thing that you were doing is lazy, it's kind of frustrating. So that's strike number two. Strike number three, there's been a lot of bugs reported. There's the MIDI bug that people are reporting, where sometimes the game plays MIDI music instead of the regular music, which baffles me, because why would the MIDI music even be in here, first of all? Why wouldn't you just replace the files rather than move them? Like, I don't know, understand how that even works. And then there's been some other bugs reported. I don't know, maybe we'll run into some. If they're super rampant, then we'll run into some. If they're not, then it's just a couple of people complaining. It's not a big deal, but they're really, hopefully it's stuff they'll fix, but who knows if they'll even fix it, because the game's already out. So that's frustrating as well. For me, I think maybe one of the biggest things that frustrates me about this port is that they just didn't do anything else, you know? Like, these remasters always frustrate me, because it feels like they could do more with them, and they just don't. You know? Like, take for example, legitimately any Blu-ray you've ever bought, right? What do they always have on Blu-rays? Behind the scenes, or some kind of like visual, concept art, or just something they got from the making of the movie, or the making of the, even if they don't have, like, for example, in the Blu-rays, the Disney Blu-rays, where they take like old movies and refresh them for Blu-ray, sometimes they don't have anything from the old movie because the movie's too old, but then they'll include stuff about the Blu-ray, and they'll include like videos about them upscaling and how they did the upscaling process. And that's super, like, interesting to me. I love watching stuff like that. I actually did a report back in college about upscaling and how it works and how we keep film through the ages. So, like, that stuff's really cool. And with these remasters, with 7, 8, 9, 10, all of them, 10 at least had some stuff, but they don't add anything like that. Like, why is there not something in the main menu, that's just like extras, and you just get a little bit of extra stuff? Like, why not? I understand that people don't like when you mess with the game too much. Like the Final Fantasy VII port, for example, they removed the magic defense bug because not a lot of people knew about that, and it helps kind of make the game more balanced. But they kept in the W item glitch, even though that breaks the game, because it's a fun glitch to do. So they understand that they don't want to change the game too much. Even if it was broken back then, they're going to keep it broken now, because people want the original experience, right? But there's no reason why there shouldn't be some kind of extras in the menu just to give us something bonus. Instead it's just a literal, like, here's the game, that's it. One thing I was thinking about last night, why is there not a Triple Triad mini game on the main menu? Could you imagine if we had, like, new game, continue, options, and then there was, like, Triple Triad Arena, and you click that, and it's just like every Triple Triad person in the game, and you can just pick one and just play Triple Triad against them. And maybe you can customize the rules also, and maybe you can choose one of your save files and import your cards, or maybe it starts off, you just get a pack of cards, and then you have to win the cards, and it's like an extra bonus mode where you can only get the cards in that mode. Like, why not do something like that? 90% of the code's already there. Literally, all you have to do is just make the menu that says, here's the opponents. You know what I mean? Like, it just seems like it would be so easy to just do something a little extra like that to give us incentive to buy the game. I mean, like, literally the only incentive to buy this game is if you don't already have the Steam version, or you just want upscaled models. Upscaled models for $20, that's basically what you're looking at, and the cheats. So, like, if you don't care about the cheats and you don't care about the upscaled models, there's no reason to buy this. Whereas if they just added one little extra thing, like, oh, here's this little bonus minigame, then there'd be, like, so much more incentive to buy it. So, that's just my spiel. And then, the final straw, you know, we already have the three strikes. The final straw is, not only did they botch the remaster in terms of the music and the models and the backgrounds and all that, but then on top of that, they needlessly censor multiple things in the game. And that just blows my mind, because, like, you could say, okay, well, they didn't do the backgrounds because they didn't want to put any work into it. And they didn't do any minigames because they didn't want to put any work into it. But they put in work just to censor stuff. And there's no explanation as to why. It blows my mind. I'm still completely lost as to why, first of all, Siren is censored, but Shiva isn't. What's with that? Second of all, this game was rated T, and Final Fantasy 15 is rated T, and they did way more risque stuff in that game, and it's HD, 480p, you know, what? Not 480p, 1080p, 4K graphics, and they got giant bazongas in that game. So, like, what is the deal? Why would, what, who is pressuring Final Fantasy, like, who is pressuring Square Enix to censor stuff in this game? I understand if they censored stuff in Kingdom Hearts, if Disney was like, hey, what are you doing? This is a kid's game. This is Disney. You can't be doing that. That I understand. Who's pressuring Square Enix to censor Final Fantasy VIII Remastered? There's no one. It doesn't exist. There's no person that was calling up Sony and they're like, listen, I loved Final Fantasy VIII back in the day, but I want my kids to experience Final Fantasy VIII, but I don't want them to play the version I had. I want them to play the version you're making now, but I want you to censor the stuff that I saw back then. No one's doing that. That doesn't exist. That, like, in Final Fantasy XV and all the games they're making now, like, they'll do whatever they want, but then they're going to go back and censor this game, put in extra work. That's what blows my mind. Put in extra work to censor stuff in this game when they didn't put in any other work to do anything else in the game. Like, what? You know? So, it's... this remaster is very baffling. And I cannot give it a good rating. Luckily, it's great for us. It's a great thing for us. We get to play Final Fantasy VIII and enjoy it. And if we see some goofy things with the remaster, we can meme about it, and it'll be fun. And I'm still looking forward to playing through it. But if I were to give this remaster, like, a rating out of 10 in terms of remasters, it's sitting at a 2 for me. Like, this is terrible. I mean, there's so many things that they could have done better, you know? Like, it's a bad remaster. We'll leave it at that. If you want to think about it in this way, like, it's Final Fantasy VIII for $20. So, you know, it's worth it if you want Final Fantasy VIII for $20. I don't think it's a bad purchase. But at the end of the day, like, it's a bad remaster, you know? Alright, let me play this sub. Tamond with the beautiful 2 months. What's better than joining the live with a resub? Nothing at all. Also, I saw a couple people, well, mostly just Bubbly, saying that there was an issue with my webcam. Let me reset my webcam real quick just in case. Yeah, I feel like it's probably just an issue with your bandwidth, but I'll do that. See if that helps. Alright, to the game. I haven't been here for a while. Yo, Mr. Guy, thank you for the 5 months. Let's get this sub train going. Thanks so much. What time is it? It's after midnight. Oh well. How'd you know that, Squall? He just looked around and then somehow figured out the time. I, Quistis Trep, am no longer an instructor as of now. I'm a member of Seed now, just like you. Who knows? Maybe we'll end up working together. Do they ever explain why she makes that change? Oh, really? Is that all you're gonna say? If that's how it was decided, you have to abide by it. Is anyone else having an issue with the webcam? Because I'm not really seeing this issue that Bubbly's talking about. Like, I want to fix it for him, but I don't see the... Like, my webcam seems like it's... You're having the issue too? So what... I'm sorry, tell me again what the issue is. It's slightly delayed from my audio or my vision... Like... I'm not sure I understand. Because to me, like... I wish I was in a menu or something, but... So you're saying, like, what I'm saying is coming out of my mouth before you see me talk? I can't imagine why that would be a... I can't imagine why that would happen. My webcam is not delayed, so it would... That would mean my microphone is delayed, but that's, like, impossible. I think it might be a placebo. Because might be a gazebo. Oh, did I deafen you for a second? I apologize. Oh, shoot. Yeah, I see what I did. I set my microphone to default for a second, so it picked up my video sound. But it put on the filter of my microphone. So yeah, that probably annihilated everyone's ears. I apologize. Sorry. Yeah, I don't know. I think it's a placebo, guys. Because, like, it looks fine to me. Like, I can see my microphone going up, and I can see me talking. And it looks normal. Like, it looks like it always does. Clap a couple times. Don't get me wrong, I'm very glad you brought it up. I always ask people to bring up audio issues because it's something I can't really see on my end. But I think it's the same as it always is. I don't see any issues on my side. If there is an issue, it's not anything I can fix at the moment. So, but thank you for bringing it up. I appreciate it. They told me that I failed as an instructor, basically that I lacked leadership qualities. Oh, okay, that's why she quit. You didn't quit, you got fired. You suck. I mean, you do kind of suck. You kind of let Cypher just, like, do his thing. I would have gotten rid of him a long time ago. I was a seed by the age of 15, got my instructor license at 17. It's only been a year since I got it. You're only 18? Wait. Quistis is 18? Wait. I wonder where I went wrong. I did my best. Are you listening? Are you done yet? God, I forgot how young everyone is in this game. That's so weird, because, like, Final Fantasy VII, I'm used to everyone being, like, early 20s. And I mean, but it makes sense because they're all in school. But like, okay, like Squall kind of looks 17. Like he's got kind of like a baby face thing going on. But Quistis looks like she's 25. I don't want to talk about it. What am I supposed to say about other people's problems? I'm not asking you to say anything. I just want you to listen. Then go talk to a wall. Got him. Aren't there times where you want to share your feelings with someone? Everyone has to take care of themselves. I don't want to carry anyone's burden. No wonder Cypher never listened to Quistis. She's 17. No leadership qualities, failed instructor, perhaps they're right. Look at her face, though. Does she not look like she's 20? Thank you for the 25 bits, Tamon, and thank you for the 500 bits, final link. Big bits. I come for the games, I stay for the fountain of knowledge. You came to the wrong place, and I'm more like a sprinkler. I'm more like a sprinkler. Like, if you're standing... If you're standing out in the yard, I'm like a sprinkler. Like, I'm missing, like, most of the time. I'm like, miss, and then I get to you and I'm like, knowledge, and then miss, knowledge. That's me. 90% of the time, I'm wrong all the time, but 10% of the time, I'm right on. Solly, thank you for the 11 months. Is the sub train still going? Thanks to you, it is. I'm still not sure I fully understand the storyline of this game. Looking forward to Death's breakdown as we progress. We're all little kids. That's it. Also, by the way, I still got Persona 4 on my list to play at some point for you. I know you asked me to play Persona 4 a while ago. I still have that written down. I'm still playing it at some point. I mean, I played it a little bit, but I want to play more of it. Why are we... Oh, shoot. I turned on God mode on accident. I was like, why do we have our limits? I played it on stream a long time ago. But I plan on playing it again at some point. At least a little bit. Somebody help! Come on, Squall. Squall, Quisty. Protect lasts in this game. I'm hoping a long time. I know, this whole training area is not a good idea. I don't know what they were thinking. Not sure what the idea was. Do you do any incentives for sponsoring a weekly Let's Play thing? Not publicly, but if you ever want to do something like that, you can always message me and tell me what you're thinking and we can figure something out. What's up, Dragoon? Yeah, this is on PS4. The remaster is not the greatest, but if you want to just play Final Fantasy VIII on your PS4, it's only 20 bucks. It's pretty worth it. Just keep in mind, it's not the best remaster ever. It does have trophies, and shockingly, the trophies are actually pretty good. Believe it or not, I still don't believe it. But shockingly, they're not the worst trophies ever, like Final Fantasy 7 and 9. Mostly 9. Yeah, it's a trophy for beating Omega Weapon. Or no, Ultimate Weapon. There's no Omega in this game, is there? Oh no, there is. Right before Eden, right? He gives you Eden, right? Okay, protect just wore off. That was pretty long. I should show you guys one of my favorite typos of all time. I've showed it off on stream before, but seeing as though we're playing Final Fantasy VIII, it'd probably be a good time to show it off. I'll show you after this boss. Oh, he already woke up. What's up, Mark? Mark Sist. Why that was so hard for me to say. I tried to say it the way that, like, it looked. Instead of just saying Marxist, I tried to say it, like, with an X. Like, Marxist. I do not remember what wizard stones do. Oh, I'm so weak. Oh, now we're jumping in. Help. It is not safe here. Please, let's go. What's going on with that guy's arms? Why are their arms so long? These look like Guado people. Are those Guados? I guess their arms are normal length. I don't know why. They just look so weird. Who is that? Alright, hold on. I gotta show you my favorite typo of all time. I've showed this before, but it's worth it to show it again. So, this is the original Final Fantasy VIII Brady Guide, and the Final Fantasy IX Brady Guide, I think it's Brady Guide, was awful. Like, the worst guide of all time, right? This one actually isn't bad, but it has an insane amount of typos in it. Like, enough to where if you just flip around, you'll find them. Like, that they're really bad. I don't know why there's so many typos. And it's not like, I don't think this was... It's a Brady guide, so I don't think it was converted from, like, Japanese. Like, it was written in English. So I don't know why, but there's just an insane amount of typos. But my favorite typo, let me find it. Okay, so on each of the pages, this is what the pages look like, right? So you got, like, this is the Deep Sea Research Center side quest. And I actually like this guide quite a bit, the way it's laid out. It has, like, all the side quests, and it tells you, like, what you can get during the side quest here and stuff. And then the bosses have, like, a big red box, and it shows all their info, right? So, I was flipping through this as a kid, trying to look at, like, the hardest bosses. And I flip over to, oh my god, it's Ultima Weapon! Holy crap, Ultima Weapon is no pushover. This beast has one-hit kill spells and powerful magic spells that attack the entire party simultaneously. You'll have to use every advantage you have in your arsenal to defeat it. Oh my god, this guy sounds so strong. I wonder how much HP he has. 1,068. Woo! You better watch out for that Ultima Weapon, boys. He's got so... You could possibly kill him with, like, a fire. Maybe a few blizzards. It's always cracked me up. It confused me as a kid. I was like, wait a second, what the heck? What do you mean he has 1,000 HP? And I think in the bestiary, it gives the right amount. this way. In the bestiary, it gives him his right amount, which if it will focus. There's a lot of white on this page, so it's going to be hard for the book to focus. I could change my webcam settings, but it's not that important. It's 51,000 to 160,000. But yeah, that typo always cracked me up. And there's a ton of them in this guide. But still way better than the Final Fantasy IX guide. Still 1,000 times better than the Final Fantasy IX guide. Hey, Warks, thank you for the 50 bits. Tamin, thank you for the 130 bits. You guys are on fire this morning. Thank you. Yeah, I mean, like, the Final Fantasy IX guide isn't even bad. It's literally a ripoff. Like, calling it bad is like, giving it a compliment. It's not even a guide. Squall, it's not like everyone can get by on their own, you know? There is a Final Fantasy X guide, and surprisingly, it's amazing. Like, the Final Fantasy VII guide was a solid 9 out of 10. Final Fantasy VIII guide, 7 out of 10. Final Fantasy IX guide, negative 1,000 out of 10. Final Fantasy X guide, like, 9.5 out of 10. Like, really good guide. It even came with a giant poster that I still have, I think, that shows all of Riku's mixes on one side, and then the other side, the other side has the entire sphere grid. And it's like a giant poster that comes out. So, yeah, the 10 guide was great. I liked the 10 guide a lot. Had a really nice side quest section, too. What do I think? What do I think of what? This remaster? I talked about it earlier. It's garbage. Says who? Says you. Why is it so quiet? Am I supposed to go to my dorm and just, like, sleep or something? Mm-hmm. S level 5, 3,000 gold, first salary trophy. Alright. I've never felt more amazing just walking around. Finally, there you are. Where the hell were you? I was looking all over the place. We're both now members of Seed, right? Well, guess what? We got our own rooms, baby. Your new room's right across the hall from your old one. That's what I was asked to tell you. Man, it took me forever. You look kind of goofy, just like frozen in place there. Look alive, Zell. Sweet room. I'll just go to sleep. Hey, wait, I was gonna check out my room. Well, it's our first Seed mission. Look like we're going to Timber. Meet by the front gate. Hurry. This is how you tell people what their mission is? You just yell at them while they're sleeping? Seems like a terrible way to go about things. It's a terribly unorganized organization.
That's it! I've come up with a new recipe.
Come up with a new recipe! Why are these guys talking so fast? Came and read what they're saying. You guys want to play some cards? No? Where's this kid? I need my revenge. I want that Mog card. And I want my revenge for him beating me up earlier. There he is. You're going down, little boy. I got the good cards now. Oh, come on. Play your Mog, you loser. Hey, get back here! Play your Mog. I came for your Mog. I'm not. Oh, there it is! The Mog has landed. About to get wiped. Just got wiped. Give me that Mog. That's all I wanted. You're a loser now. You don't have any good cards. You're a loser. Never play with you again. See, before I felt like it was silly that I would act this way. But now that I know that Squall's 17, it makes total sense. A 17-year-old would definitely, like, walk up to some little kid playing Yu-Gi-Oh, take his good cards, and then never play with them again. One more minute. Oh my god. Okay, Tony Hawk. Made it. T-boards are prohibited within Garden. Have you forgotten? Oops, sorry. This is really cool. It may come in handy on a seed mission someday. We'll be the judges of that. Why is the garden faculty, like, literally the most mean people in existence? Sid's, like, super nice, and then the faculty is just like, we're all jerks. Nevertheless, you're still students of this garden. Furthermore, because you are seeds, you must set an example to all others and abide by the garden's rules. Understood? Well, about your first mission. You are to go to Timber. There you'll be supporting a resistance faction. That is your mission. A member of the faction will contact you at Timber Station. This person will talk to you and say, the forests of Timber sure have changed. At this time you must reply, but the owls are still around. That is the password. Just follow the faction's orders. Just us three? Correct. We have agreed to do this mission for very little money. Normally we would never accept such requests, but... enough talk about that. Wait, okay, wait a second. Normally we wouldn't do this for so little money, but seeing as though you guys are losers and we want you out of the garden, we just accepted it anyways. Well then, Squall, you are the squad leader. Use your best judgment based on the situation. Zell and Selfie, you are to support Squall and give your all to carry out the faction's plans. Wanna play some cards? It's a cursed item, but if one with enough power uses it, it should be of great help. Oh yeah, we got the lamp! Once again, the password is... blah blah blah. I don't forget about your owls. I don't care about your owls. What are you doing? Play some cards. You know what? I really like this garden, even though there are instructors who suck. Wow. Real talk. Oh. Like that crappy Quistis character. Alright. I really like how all the characters show up in the menu, even when they're not in the party. Just so you can like easily turn off their stuff. Alright, you can have Dermo. Actually, well, I don't know. Should I give Zell? You would think that giving Zell the strength thing would be smart, but honestly, Squall does so much more damage. Oh, there's no gameplay changes other than the cheats, Dragoon. If you want to hear more about the remaster, you can go to the videos tab up above and then click this stream and then go back to the beginning of when I started playing because I talked a bunch about it at the beginning. Or you can just wait for the first episode on YouTube, which would be episode 5. It'll be next, like, Monday. Else have strength junction. Oh, Shiva does. Dressed Snake with the brand new Twitch Prime sub. Thank you so much. And Phoenix with the 500 bits. Holy crap. And Fab, thanks again for the 115, the new reciper. Appreciate it, dude. So if I remember correctly, this is my favorite part of the game. If it's the part I'm thinking it is. Hey, thanks, Dress. Glad you enjoy the Complete Chaos Challenge. That was a fun one. So do we rub this lamp and get, like, completely wrecked or what? That was a weird noise. I'm a magician. He really is the most handsome guy here. Oh, I need to reset. You. What do I want you to get? Magic plus 20%. I should give Dermo to Wall. So, I did that because I'm gonna make, like, Siren more of, like, a magic build. Because she is. She gets, like, magic plus 20%. And so Selfie's gonna be, like, the magic caster here. And I'm just giving Squall all strength stuff. God. 100 fires gives him so much strength. It's insane. Silence there is pretty cool. Don't give your followers away. What's up, Darky? What do I think of the remaster? If you go back to the beginning of this video, I talk all about it, but it's a really bad remaster, but worth the money if you just want to play Final Fantasy VIII on PS4, is basically the synopsis. It's a really terrible remaster, to be honest, but it's not broken enough to where it's not worth, you know, $20 just to be able to play Final Fantasy VIII again. But it's not bad bad, like it functions fine, but in terms of what they could have done, it's a big letdown. It could look better, there's bugs that happen, there's very strange censorship that happens, and a load of other things, but like I said, for $20 to be able to play Final Fantasy VIII upscaled on your PS4 with cheats, it's not a bad deal. But to be honest, if you like playing games on your PC, I would probably recommend just getting the PC version and modding it. Because it's probably a much better experience. Especially since there's some crazy good mods for FF8. If you're into that kind of thing. I don't remember if we're even supposed to go here or not. I was thinking I had the drive to Timber, but... Yeah. I've heard a lot of stuff about you. Huh? What stuff? Heh, lots of bad stuff. You have every right to worry. Hardly, you're like a legend here. No way, what'd he do? Well, I guess he's most known for doing the most grueling pull-ups. What? See that sign up there? Once he climbed up there and did 100 pull-ups, can you imagine that? Yeah, what do you guys think about that, huh? I think he needs some help. Got him. That's coming from Selfie, too. Hate to see that. Interested in taking a trip? Rent a car today. It's fun and safe, too. Which one do you want? They're both 3,500 gil. Alright, boys. Do we get the sky blue van or the classic car? Are we going mom van or are we going classic? Boy, rental cars. I say forget it. Come on, we gotta get a car. It's looking like mom van. Where it? Oh, there it is! How do I... Oh yeah! Talk about upscaling. This is where it's at. This car's gotta be at least 8K graphics. This is an 8K graphic vehicle. What is even the point of this? There's nothing here. I'm getting paid to do absolutely nothing. I'm getting paid to drive around in circles in a mom van. Oh god, I'm stuck. Why would you want to do this? Why would you want to rent a car? There's nowhere to go here. This is like the smallest continent or the smallest area. How do I even go back? Can I even go back? Oh my god, the door was like broken. You see that? Well, that was fun. Buy anything before you go? We carry various gifts. Oh boy, a gift. Hey mom, I got you some shotgun ammo and a G potion. Said nobody ever. Well, I wouldn't mind a returner or two. God, remedies are expensive in this game. I don't know, I just bought random crap. The train of timber is here. Oh my god, dude. All my gil is gone. Hey, wanna play some cards? Thank you. This train is awesome! The Transcontinental Railroad, baby. It even runs through an underwater tunnel to get to timber. Pretty cool, huh? Sure is. Guess you're not interested. You Squall, dude. By the way, Squall, you have to use the ticket to get inside. Technology. Okay, we can go inside now. Confirming, access granted. I'm gonna go check out the front. Teehee, thanks. Let's go check it out, Squall. Am I the only one that, like, hates Squall's character? Because he's... We've had this discussion many times on the stream. But he's... Yikes. He's so bored. Like, I don't know. To me, being, like, a cool guy and being boring are, like, two separate things. And to me, Squall is just boring. He's always come across as boring to me, not, like, cool. Like, there's standoff-y characters that are, like, too cool to talk to anyone. But then there's just, like, boring characters. To me, Squall kind of... He feels more boring. But it does get a little better later, yo. Like I said, it's been so long since I played this that maybe I forget a lot about him. But it's definitely the beginning. Like, the beginning of the game, I've always felt like he's just boring. I don't really care about him too much. Yo, check it out. So this is Seed's private cabin. Whoa! Oh, yeah! Awesome! Haha, this is so cool! I'm glad you're so excited. They even have magazines here. Pet Pals! Oh yeah. This is pretty dang amazing. It pays to be a member of Seed. Squall, you know anything about timber? Thought so. Well, let me fill you in. Timber used to be a country surrounded by deep forests. But 18 years ago, Galbadia invaded. Timber fell quite easily to Galbadia. So now timber is under Galbadian occupation. It is said there's a whole bunch of resistance factions, big and small. And? Nope, that's it. Thank you, Mr. Know-It-All Zell. Hey, no prob. I'm not feeling well. You should get some rest if you're tired. I'm really sleepy. You okay? Hey, what the? What is he doing? Something's wrong with me too. I feel sleepy. What's going on? What is this? Game over.